chance to turn back. Yeah, I didn't think so. Can't blame me for trying, though, can you?
After what happened to your mum.
Shelby’s could have smuggled you into the funeral, you know.
Okay, forgetting your damn talk.
Shelby’s bed. I'd go to prison and you'd be put to death. Come on, get out the bloody way. Oi! Get up the van or I'll give you a fucking strike. Keep your head down. I'll get us through. Welcome back to Small Heath. Listen. Tommy Shelby's in charge now, but Arthur's convinced him to give you a chance. You've got to take it. The deserter's got no other choice. Still, you'd better look the part. Ever wash in that sink? Grab some clean overalls from that locker. Shelby's overseer, now I'm here. You're not the only bit of business I've had to handle today. Well, if the van door's open, close them, would ya? Then, meet me outside. Found one of my cards. Keep it, Sam. For good luck. You're eager, ain't ya? All right then, close up the van and meet me outside when you're done.
was of a poppy, drawn by a different hand. I remembered hearing of the market.
Hands over, all suit you. Take this note. It's from Arthur, in case anyone asks any questions. Anyway, I'll best start packing these crates. So I'm always waiting for you in the pub. Watch yourself. He's not the little lad you know.
Line the border fires and the humming wires, Emmanuel. of a kind. Across the square, across the bridge, across the mills, across the sea. In a gathering storm comes a tall, handsome man in a dusty black coat with a red right hand.
I never told them anything.
Oh. Come in. Let me get a look at you. Well, the time's not been kind to you, eh? You still smoke? What's it been? 10 years? More? Still can't talk after all this time. That old bastard really did a number on you, didn't he? But compared to your old man, ours was a fucking dream. We were just kids last I saw you. And now I've got Arthur in my ear saying give him a chance. Ever heard of this? Churchill's place was robbed last night. Got away with the King's ransom. Jewelry, fine china, family heirlooms. Churchill's far more worried about this. This was stolen from his nightstand as he slept. Looks like a briefcase. Well, it's not. It's Churchill's dispatch box, stuffed with government secrets. Now, God forbid it falls into the wrong hands. Which is where we come in. Have a seat. We'll talk business.
A toast.
To old friends. The documents in that red box name every British undercover agent worldwide. Whoever's got it could blow the lid off the Empire, start a new war. So Churchill's asked me to personally see that he gets it back, and he will reward the Shelby Company handsomely for his troubles. Luckily, I was able to locate it. My man in London was due to deliver it here this morning. He called before he set off. No one's seen eye nor hair of him since. One way or another, someone's got to him. Now I need a trustworthy soldier to go down there and find the truth. I normally ask my brother, but this needs a surgeon, not a butcher. You might just be that man. I've seen your war record. Have a read. Paints a grim picture. But I can change that. Now, Arthur, he remembers what you did for him back in the old day. But I'm not Arthur. How do I know you're anything but a traitor? He's got this coming to him. I'm not convinced just yet. Abraham's man betrayed me. He's in there. Take care of him. Job's yours.
I'll see to it your name is cleared.
Can't see Polly at the betting shop. Give her this. Or we can just fuck off. It's up to you.
Yes. someone there.